Hello and a very good evening. You're watching the news tonight on Rajya Sabha Television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are this evening's headlines. Parliament convenes for winter session. Lok Sabha adjourns for the day after obituary references to former members, world leaders and sitting TMC MP Renuka Sinha. Demonetization debate begins in the Rajya Sabha. Opposition leaders target centre, calling its move ill-timed and ill-conceived. Government counters the charge, says move is being welcomed by people. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee leads TMC march to Rashtrapati Bhavan, petitions President on the decision to demonetize high-value currency notes. And chaotic scenes and long queues continue outside bank ATMs and across the country. Cash-strapped people complain of ATMs running out of cash and non-functional machines. Well, the month-long winter session of Parliament began today. The session began in the shadow of the government's week-old measure to scrap 500 and 1,000 rupee banknotes. The move that was meant to drain illegal cash from the economy has had a less than smooth rollout. With millions queuing up outside banks to deposit or exchange old currency, the poor and small traders are the hardest hit. The upper house of Parliament debated the issue. In the Lok Sabha, the first day of the winter session was adjourned soon after tributes paid to members who passed away. Sitting MP from West Bengal's Kuch Bihar, Renuka Sinha, breathed her last in August this year. Well, the opposition Congress today upped the ante against the government in the Rajya Sabha over the issue of demonetization. Congress leader Anand Sharma alleged selective leakage of the news about the demonetization and demanded disclosure of black money holders in foreign banks. The government, on the other hand, hit back at the opposition and defended the demonetization decision.
The opposition Congress on Wednesday launched an aggressive attack on the government for its demonetization notification. Deputy leader of the Congress in the upper house, Anand Sharma, accused the government of displaying blatant insensitivity to the misery of the common man. He alleged that an atmosphere is being created where questioning the government is being dubbed anti-national. Expressing concern over Prime Minister Narendra Modi's statement that his life is in danger for making the demonetization announcement, the Congress leader sought an investigation into the matter.
Sarkar ye bayan de, aaj se sansad ka sheetkalin satra aarambh ho gaya. Ab aap batao, Pradhan Mantri ji, Grah Mantri ke Pradhan Mantri, ye kya suchna sarkar ke paas hai? Kaun si saazish hai? Kaun se sangathan hai? Kaun se log hain jo Bharat ke Pradhan Mantri ki hatya karna chahte?
Delivering a sharp rebuttal, Union Minister Piyush Goyal said the government's step honored the honest while troubling the dishonest. He asserted that despite standing in long queues, people are welcoming the Prime Minister's initiative.
I understand that no one has stopped his money in the bank. If there is a stop, then it is for unbelievers. If there is a stop, then it is for corruptors. If there is a stop, then it is for those who keep false notes. अब पूरे सदन में ऐसा कौन सा सदस्य है जो ऐसे प्रतिबंध पे भी एतराज कर रहा है?
Various members also sought the Prime Minister's presence in the House to heed the opposition's concerns over the demonetization drive.
ये अति संवेदनशील मामला है, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को आप इधर बुलाएं और वो हमारी बात सुने और मैं समझती हूँ कि नेता सदन इसके ऊपर
अभी बैठिए
तो प्रधानमंत्री जी इसके ऊपर जवाब तो ज्यादा बेहतर होगा, ये मेरी नेता सदन से रिक्वेस्ट है।
माननीय प्रधानमंत्री सभी विपक्ष के नेताओं की भाषण चाहे ऑल पार्टी मीटिंग में सुने या सदन के अंदर सुने तो बहुत सारी गलत फहमियां दूर हो सकती हैं, बहुत चीजों के बारे में उन्हें जानकारी भी रह सकती है। तो चूंकि आज लोकसभा में माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने हैं, तो मायावती जी ने जो मांग की थी और मेरे ख्याल में सभी यादव जी की भी, शरद जी की भी और दूसरी पार्टीज की भी सबकी वही मांग है।
In an effort to tackle hoarding of black money, corruption and terror financing, Prime Minister Modi on November 8th announced that all 500 and 1,000 currency notes will cease to be valid in all forms of transactions. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
The discussion on the issue continued in the post-lunch session too, with opposition leaders pointing out several lapses in the demonetization move. The discussion will continue on Thursday.
Participating in the discussion over demonetization, the opposition parties took on the government, citing several lapses in implementation.
Pradhan Mantri ji ne ped to aam ka lagana chaha tha, lekin wo babool ka nikal gaya. Usme itne kaante nikle ki desh ki aam janta ko उससे बहुत ज्यादा कष्ट हुआ।
इन्होंने किया है जो एनपीए हुआ है, एनपीए आपके मित्रों का, जो कर्जा माफ किया है, ब्याज माफ किया है 1,10,000 करोड़, इससे जो पैसा आएगा आप अपने एनपीए करने वाले दोस्तों को फिर कर्जा देने के लिए आप इकट्ठा कर रहे हो, जिससे काला धन उन लोगों के पास जाए जिन उद्योगपतियों का अकाउंट खाता एनपीए डिक्लेयर हो गया है, इसलिए आप कर रहे हो। आपकी नियत देश को सुधारने की नहीं है, देश तो उसी दिन सुधर जाएगा जिस दिन आप सुधर जाओगे।
Opposition members also sought relaxation in norms to ease the difficulties being faced by the people. Raising the issue of the decision being leaked ahead of the announcement, they also sought an investigation by the JPC.
The Prime Minister now said, I'm shocked. He said 50 days more is required. 50 days more is required for alternative arrangements to come into place. Till that alternative arrangements are not in place, allow these notes to be transacted for all white transactions and public utilities and public purposes.
ये बेहतर होगा कि ये जो जांच है तो ये जेपीसी से हो जाती तो ज्यादा बेहतर होता, लेकिन ये जांच समयबद्ध होनी चाहिए। ये केवल ऐसे नहीं कि जेपीसी सरकार वाले सोच रहे होंगे हम मान लेंगे, समयबद्ध होनी चाहिए।
But the government and its allies put up a strong defense, saying the decision would help eradicate black money and tackle corruption.
Sir, this is literally a war on corruption and black money. You have to decide on which side you are. People are sending a congratulatory message to the Prime Minister and to all of us, but I don't know why some people are so agitated, because they are agitated only for one thing. They are agitated because the popularity graph of the Prime Minister is going up.
This discussion will continue on Thursday.
The discussion will not be over today. Discussion will be spilled over, carried over to tomorrow also. And then in the BSE, which is the rightful body to allocate time, this issue was raised at 1 p.m. The BSE, the statutory body, and there it was decided that 9 hours. See, 9 hours is allotted for this, and therefore tomorrow from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. or even further more.
Vishal Daya's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, the government has made it clear that bank loans against liquor baron Vijay Mallya and other defaulters have not been waived off. Intervening during the demonetization debate in the Rajya Sabha, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley clarified there was no loan waiver and the liability on the borrowers remains. Further explaining, Jaitley said that while the government will continue to chase the loan, the entry in the accounting book will change from performing assets to a non-performing one. This after controversy arose over India's largest bank, the State Bank of India, reportedly writing off loans worth 7,000 crore rupees of 63 willful defaulters, including Vijay Mallya.
It doesn't mean that the loan ceases to be a loan. So you still pursue the loan. The entry in the books changes. That is, from being a performing asset, it becomes a non-performing asset. A performing asset is one where interest is being serviced. Non-performing, where interest is not being serviced, but you will still continue to preserve it. So don't, there is a little bit of a malapropism involved in this. Don't go by the literal meaning of write-off. Doesn't mean rin mafi in banking terms.
Meanwhile, escalating her protest against demonetization, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on Wednesday led the protest march to Rashtrapati Bhavan. She was joined only by parliamentarians of her party and a representative each from the Aam Aadmi Party and the National Conference. Surprisingly, and in a fair embarrassment for the government, NDI ally Shiv Sena also joined the march.
West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee led a protest march to Rashtrapati Bhavan on Wednesday, seeking President Pranab Mukherjee's intervention over the government's demonetization move. Mamata said her march was to save the common man from the looming disaster owing to the move, terming the current situation as financial emergency.
ऐसा परिस्थिति हो गया कि एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल क्राइसिस हो गया, एक फाइनेंशियल कैलामिटीज हो गया, एक फाइनेंशियल इमरजेंसी हो गया। हमने हम लोगों ने मिलके, ओमर जी ने बहुत बढ़िया बोला, मान ने बोला, अधिशूल जी ने बोला, पूरा खुल खुल कर बोला कि ये देखिए पहले आप नॉर्मलसी रेस्टोर कीजिए।
Apart from her party MPs, Mamata Banerjee was joined by a small group of leaders from the Aam Aadmi Party and National Conference leader Omar Abdullah.
जो काले धन वाले असली हैं, उनको पकड़िए। विजय माल्या 9000 करोड़ लेके भाग गया इंग्लैंड में, उनको वापस लेके आइए। स्विस बैंक में कितने पैसे पड़े हैं, उनका हिसाब दीजिए।
In an embarrassment for the government, NDA ally Shiv Sena sent its MPs to join the march. The party, however, maintained a different stand, saying it was not opposed to demonetization, but just the inconvenience caused to people.
काले धन वाले तो रोज लंबे रहेंगे, लेकिन जो सही जिसके पास सफेद धन है उसको तकलीफ हो रही है। बैंकों में जाओ तो अपना खुद का पैसा निकाल नहीं सकते, भरना है तो 4000 के एक्सचेंज करना है तो 4000 करना है, निकालना है तो 2000, कैसे होगा।
Leaders of other opposition parties, including Congress, the left parties, SP and BSP, stayed away from the march, saying they wanted to raise the issue in Parliament first before escalating the matter to the President. With inputs from Anu Divan and Ravindra Sharan, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, there seems to be no respite from the cash crunch in the country, even 8 days after the government's demonetization announcement. Long queues in front of banks and ATMs continued, with some bank branches unable to dispense cash. Political parties too continued their attack on the centre over mismanagement of the scheme.
Chaotic scenes were seen outside banks and ATMs as queues continued to swell across the country on Wednesday. With thousands of ATMs still not functional, cash-strapped people struggled with machines that ran out of cash within hours of being stocked.
लीव कैश सुबह 5 बजे का घूम रहा हूँ, 4 ATM में जाके आ गया, सब में कैश खत्म था, इधर आया लाइन में लगा पड़ा हूँ अभी। अब जहाँ पे मिलेगा नहीं मिलेगा कोई भरोसा नहीं है जहाँ का।
मैं रात से घूम रहा हूँ, रात को आया था यहाँ पे ATM में लाइन में लगा था, नंबर आया, पैसे खत्म हो गए। अभी सुबह 5 बजे उठा, सेक्टर 9 गया, सेक्टर 12 गया, वहाँ पैसे नहीं, मुनिरका गया, मुनिरका के सारे ATM की खाक छान के आया, अब यहाँ आके लाइन में लगा पड़ा।
रात से ATM में घूम रहा हूँ मगर कैश कहीं नहीं मिल रहा, और मैं कल डॉक्टर के पास गया, डॉक्टर ने मैंने बोला, मैंने कहा आप पुराना वाला 500 का नोट ले लो, तो उन्होंने साहब मना कर दिया लेने से। तो ये चीज गलत है, अगर कहीं भी किसी की तबीयत खराब है, दिक्कत है, तो उसको एटलीस्ट उसको फेवर करना चाहिए कि ले लेना चाहिए।
ने किया बहुत बढ़िया, अच्छा किया जो मोदी सरकार ने किया, सबको हम बराबर करने के लिए।
क्यों लाइन में?
हाँ, हम सुबह से क्यों ठहरा भरे तू, हम 100 का 50 का नोट कम है, 1500 को भरे सो भाई, उसलिए वैसे 4-5 दिन दिक्कत होंगे।
Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi once again hit out at the centre over its demonetization decision, alleging that no action was taken against the real black marketeers. He claimed that BJP members were alerted about the demonetization much before the announcement. Tripura Chief Minister Manik Sarkar urged the centre to allow the use of old currency notes till the 30th of December to ease the inconveniences of the public. Odisha Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik also spoke to the Prime Minister about the plight of farmers after cooperative banks were told not to exchange demonetized notes.
Demonetization ka nirnay liya, decision liya. Aap sabko kasht ho raha hai. Aap line mein lage ho. Koi aapko ameer vyakti, hazaron crore rupaye wala vyakti dikhai de raha hai line mein? 1,10,000 crore रुपए उनके माफ किए गए हैं पिछले 2 साल में।
Meanwhile, while banks in some parts of the country started using election ink, other regions complained of not receiving the ink in time on Wednesday. The Election Commission has also told the Finance Ministry to keep in mind election laws on the use of indelible ink, as 5 states will go for by polls on the 19th of November. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, over the past 8 days, the government has announced several measures to ease the problems being faced by the people due to demonetization. One of these includes taking the banks to the people, especially in rural areas. The government claims banking correspondents have been assigned this job. Our correspondent Shyam Sundar gets you this ground report.
In a bid to bring the rural population into the banking fold, the government often functions through customer care centers in remote areas. Now the government wants to use these centers for the exchange of old notes as well. But the problem is that most of these centers are in towns and cities, leaving the population in the villages in the lurch. Even bank correspondents have not yet reached villages.
उसके सबसे बड़ी वजह तो कनेक्टिविटी, उसके बाद अगर हम लोग गांव जा रहे हैं तो फिर यहां सेंटर बंद रहेगा, तो यहां पब्लिक आएगी, यहां वो परेशान होगी। मान लो अपन कोई गांव जा रहे हैं और यहां आसपास के 10 गांव से आ रहे हैं, अपन प्रॉपर एक गांव जा पाएंगे एक दिन में? कनेक्टिविटी की प्रॉब्लम है, ब्रॉडबैंड से चलता है, डोंगल से अपन चलाए या मोबाइल से चलाए तो उतना बेटर रिजल्ट नहीं मिलता।
Besides, these centers get just 50,000 rupees every day for transactions. Also, they do not have the mandate to exchange notes instantly.
नई दिल्ली मना कर दी, अभी धुन से आ रहे हैं हम, और यहाँ हमारी तबीयत खराब, तो पैसा है ना जमा करने आए हैं, तो अभी कह रहे हैं कि 2,000 अभी जमा कर दो, बाद में कल ले जाना निकला के ऐसे बोल रहे हैं।
कल 50,000 मिला था सर हमें बैंक से, हम अपने अकाउंट में जमा करके वहाँ से नई करेंसी मिली थी हमें, उसके बाद उसका जो लेखा जोखा हमारे पास है और उसके बदले में जो अपन पुरानी नोट ले रहा है उसको आज जाएंगे, कल के लिए फिर मिल जाएगा। तो 50,000 में अपन, अब हमारी लिमिट है अभी 2,000 अपन विड्रॉल कर सकते हैं, 2,000 अपन डिपॉजिट कर सकते हैं।
As a result, bank branches are under a lot of pressure.
आप कब से लाइन में हैं?
अब तो 5 बजे आए सर।
सुबह तो अभी तक आपका अंदर जाने का नंबर नहीं आया?
हाँ, ये बैंक साहब 11 बजे खुलती है।
नहीं, 6 बजे बंद कर देते, कल हम गेट से भागे हैं सर।
अच्छा, कल भी आए थे?
जी सर, 5 दिन।
बड़ी लाठीचार्ज?
जी सर।
In rural areas, the need for small currency denominations is more as they need it for their day-to-day needs.
These long queues outside the bank show that the claims of providing service through business correspondents of different bank in rural areas are not true. And we came to know that there is no infrastructure or connectivity to provide these services in rural and especially in tribal areas. With cameraman Vijay Kumar, this is Shyam Sundar for Rajya Sabha TV from Mandla, Madhya Pradesh.
Demonetization is making vegetables scarce a commodity in some parts of Rajasthan. On the one hand, farmers are unable to sell because of the cash crunch. People, on the other hand, are digging into their savings and coming up with small change that shopkeepers are refusing to take because these coins are fake. At this local weekly market on the Kalwa Junction in Rajasthan, vegetable sellers are waiting for farmers to come with their produce. The shop owners say their supplies are dwindling rapidly. Local residents are complaining that they have no currency notes to buy vegetables. Instead, they are trying to use coins, which are being refused by the shop owners.
सर, समस्या ये है कि ग्राहक के पास में पुराना 500 का और 1,000 रुपए का नोट है। गरीब आदमी बचत करके 500-1,000 रुपए उसके पास है, तो 500 रुपए लेके बाजार में घूम रहा है, वो 500 का नोट चल नहीं रहा है, 1,000 का नोट चल नहीं रहा है। अब उसकी जरूरत की सब्जी जैसे 20-30 रुपए की है, वो 500 में कोई दुकानदार उसको वापस दे नहीं रहा।
जिसके पास पैसे है वो सब्जी खरीद रहा है, जिसके पास पैसे नहीं है वो नहीं खरीद रहा है।
आपने उनको क्या दिया?
मैंने सिक्के दिए 10-10 रुपए के।
आप बचा के रखे हुए थे?
वो पहले के बचे हुए थे, घर वालों से लेके आया हूँ, औरतों से या बच्चों से लेके आया हूँ।
स्मॉल वेंडर्स से द फेक कॉइन्स आर एडिंग टू देयर हार्डशिप्स।
चाय बिक्री को पर असर ये है कि 10 का सिक्का आता है मेरे पास में शाम को, सिर्फ 10 के सिक्के ज्यादा आते हैं, उसमें भी ये नकली बताते हैं, ये सिक्के मेरे को फिर फेंकने कोई मतलब के नहीं है।
In a strange twist, farmers, vendors and buyers are finding themselves at the receiving end of the twin menace of fake coins and currency shortage.
Earlier, the prices of these vegetables were 25 to 30 rupees per kg. Now it is 20 rupees. It has gone down. The prices have gone down because farmers are selling it at cheaper prices. Otherwise, it will be destroyed. These shopkeepers are also selling it at cheaper rate because if they don't sell it, it will be also destroyed. In this way, economy of the village rural areas have come down. Akhilesh Soman for Rajya Sabha Television with camera person Om Prakash in Kalwar area of Rajasthan.
A house with an impending wedding always has cash in hand to handle day-to-day expenses, but the government move is giving families sleepless nights as family members queue up in banks instead of preparing for the big day. With the wedding season at its peak, families are struggling to somehow manage to organize events.
Surendra Yadav is a busy man as he prepares to get his daughter married. But the retired railway officer is instead wasting precious preparation time by queuing outside banks. In fact, every family member is standing in line as they need handy cash.
आज मैं शादी है और शादी में इतने पैसे कुल 900 रुपया हमारे पास बचा है और शादी पूरी पड़ी हुई हमारी बैंक से जो लाए थे वो चला गया दे दिया मैंने थोड़ा थोड़ा सबको डिवोट कर दिया और अभी सामान अभी और भी आना है.
The bride to be Sheetal also has a worried look on her face instead of the pre-wedding glow.
शादी कम से कम शादी के जो लोग हैं उनके लिए कुछ तो आप करिए, कुछ तो कॉम्प्रोमाइज करिए. आपने तो बस अपनी एक स्कीम निकाल दी कि भैया नहीं चलेंगे. अब समस्या तो हम लोग के सामने आ रही है ना.
With each passing hour, Surendra Yadav and his wife's problems are compounded as they run short of money for wedding preparations. However, they are backing the government's move.
घर में शादी है, ज़्यादा दिक्कत नहीं है. अगर आपका कुछ भी है 15 दिन के लिए किसी को भी डिले कर सकते हो. आपका मार्केट वैल्यू क्या है, आपकी गुडविल क्या है.
पब्लिक्स क्यू दैट इज मोर देन 1 किलोमीटर लॉन्ग एंड फॉर अस इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गो आउट एंड अगेन पुट इन द कैश इन द एटीएम.
कैश क्रंच हैज फोर्स्ड पीपल टू गो बैंक टू कलेक्ट देयर मनी फॉर वेडिंग एंड हाउस होल्ड फंक्शंस. पीपल डिमांड स्पेशल अरेंजमेंट फॉर फैमिलीज who have wedding dates in this season. With camera person Vijay Singh, Navikram Singh, Rajya Sabha TV, Kasganj.
Well, let's now get you a roundup with the other national news and nationwide. An FIR was lodged against West Bengal Congress Chief Adhir Chaudhary for verbally abusing the district magistrate at a public meeting in Murshidabad last Monday. Chaudhary allegedly called him names for being close to the ruling party and helping it to rope in Congress and other non-TMC members of the Zilla Parishad in the district. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi was on Wednesday granted bail by a local court in a defamation case over his alleged comment against RSS on Mahatma Gandhi's assassination. Rahul asserted that he would carry on with his fight against Gandhi's ideology and win the battle. Now, the case against Rahul was filed by the RSS over the former's speech in Bhiwadi in 2014. Union Minister Sushma Swaraj tweeted on Wednesday that she was in the hospital because of kidney failure and is going through tests for a transplant. The revelation was followed by a flood of wishes and even offers of kidneys. The 64-year-old External Affairs Minister was admitted to the AIIMS hospital in Delhi last Tuesday. A policeman was killed in an encounter between militants and security forces in Kashmir, Sopore. The encounter, which began early on Wednesday, is currently underway. Security forces came under fire while they were on a search operation based on a tip-off. The forest area has been cordoned off and further details are awaited. A wreath-laying ceremony was held in Srinagar for the slain policeman. Moving on to some international news now. The Christian governor of Jakarta, the capital of the world's largest Muslim-majority nation, has been named a suspect in a case of alleged blasphemy. The case involving Basuki Purnama has caused severe trouble as far as the country is concerned, and Indonesia's commitment to religious tolerance and pluralism is currently being questioned. Here's a report. Indonesian National Police on Wednesday named the Christian and ethnic Chinese governor of Jakarta a suspect in an alleged blasphemy case brought against him by Muslim groups. The complaint against Basuki Tahaja Purnama, nicknamed Ahok, and the first ethnic Chinese and Christian governor of the sprawling Indonesian capital, comes as President Joko Widodo tries to keep a lid on security and simmering religious tensions in the world's biggest Muslim-majority nation.
Meskipun tidak bulat, namun didominasi oleh pendapat yang menyatakan perkara ini harus diselesaikan di peradilan yang terbuka. Konsekuensinya,
the blasphemy allegation centered on a speech Purnama made in September in which he said his opponents had deceived voters by attacking him using a verse from the Quran. Purnama has apologized for the comments, but hardline Muslim groups have demanded that he resign, claiming that he insulted the holy book. The police chief urged calm among the people and asked them to accept the result that would be delivered by the court later. They also recommended that the case be tried in an open court.
Tapi kita juga mensinyalir adanya demo-demo yang memanfaatkan momentum ini dalam rangka untuk agenda yang lain. Agenda-agenda.
More than 100,000 Muslims marched against Purnama this month, urging voters not to re-elect him in February.
Bagi saya ini di pengadilan bukan memperjuangkan sebuah kasus Ahok saja. Ini untuk menentukan arah NKRI ini mau gimana ke depan. Karena kita yakin setiap orang itu sama di muka hukum.
Purnama, a Protestant once usually popular for his tough reformist approach to running the city of 10 million, has seen his support plummet amid the controversy. A decision to drop the case could have sparked mass protests led by hardline Muslims against not just Purnama but also Widodo, who is seen as a key backer of the governor. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Let's now shift focus and bring you up to date with some sports news in Sports Beat. Ace shuttler Saina Nehwal today made a shock first-round exit from the China Open in Fuzhou. Saina lost to Thailand's Pontip 16-21, 21-19, 14-21. Saina had made a return 3 months after injuring her knee during the Rio Olympics, which was followed by a surgery and a long rehabilitation program. Rio Games silver medalist PV Sindhu, however, advanced to the pre-quarterfinals after beating Chia Hsin Lee of Chinese Taipei 21-12, 21-16. In the men's singles, H.S. Pranoy and Ajay Jayaraman also made it to the second round. Novak Djokovic became the first player to reach the semi-finals at the ATP World Tour Finals after beating Milos Raonic 7-6, 7-6 for his second match win in Group Ivan Lendl. If Djokovic goes on to win the title, he will claim the year-end number one in the Emirates ATP ranking. The Serbian now has 11,180 points, 70 more points ahead of Andy Murray. Magnus Carlsen and Sergei Kryakin played yet another draw in Game 4 on Tuesday of the World Chess Championships. Both players sat with 2 points each after the draw was agreed to on the 94th move in the match. Carlsen and Kryakin will continue their battle over the next several weeks in the scheduled 12-match championship. Lionel Messi produced a magical display to get Argentina's World Cup qualification back on track as Brazil notched their sixth consecutive victory to put 1 foot in the 2018 finals in Russia. Messi curled home a stunning 30-yard free kick and set up goals for Lucas Prato and Angel Di Maria in a 3-0 win over Colombia. The victory elevated Argentina into the qualifying places after a disastrous run of results which saw them take just 2 points from their previous four games. Well, that's it on this edition of the News Tonight. Good night.